Match game 74, production number 0281, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Charlie Brill. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joyce Bulifant. Richard Dawson. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Today, on this stage.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friend.
Here we are gathered once again. What did we gather for it? Listen, I want to point out to all of you, welcome here. We have a new kid on the block here. And we usually all applaud and give him a little warm. We want him to feel at home, don't we?
Yes.
His name is, he's a skinny guy who's sitting up on
top. You part your hair on the
there.
Other side now, don't
I'm
you?
I'm parting my hair on the other side. That's you noticed, didn't you?
Yeah.
Get
yeah,
your hand off that fat lady's blind.
What do you say we say hello to old Charlie Brill here? Nice to have you with us, Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie!
How much do you weigh?
143.
You weigh
143. I know you had more than that for breakfast.
No, we're not going to do that stuff, Charlie. You're going to have a good time here, Charlie.
Thank
I don't
you,
care
honey.
What your agent told you.
Thank you.
Now, let's say hello to our two players here, Janet Finn and Silvana Caballero. Janet Finn is our current champ, and if you've been watching the show in the last few days or week or so, she has won $18,450. And she's going to be challenged by Silvana. We didn't really have a chance to talk with you yesterday, did we, Silvana? Would you please tell us about yourself now?
Certainly. I am married, and I have two children. I'm originally from Italy, and I'm a polyglot.
You're a what?
Polyglot.
A polyglot. Mm-hmm. What the heck is a polyglot? We never had a polyglot on the show before, did we?
Well, it's the ability of speaking and understanding more than one language.
Oh, what other languages? You speak Italian, right?
Italian, French, English, and Spanish.
Italian, French. Questa è una bella ragazza.
How are you with smoke signals, darling?
Well, Silvana, I hope you have good luck here.
Thank you.
Good luck to you, Janet. You've had it already. We'll start this game right after we have a word with you, America. Here it is. Here we go. I'll push this button and ask you, Silvana Caballero. That's a pretty name to make a selection here.
A, please.
A. Miss Polyglot Lady wants A.
Okay. Polyglot cracker.
Nellie said, my husband, the baseball player, thinks love is just like spring training. When we went on our honeymoon, he brought along a blank.
I'm getting so smart at this.
I'll repeat it for everybody. Nellie said, my husband, the baseball player, thinks love is just like spring training. When we went on our honeymoon, he brought along a blank. Did you hear that, Silvana?
Mm-hmm.
You understand it?
Yes.
Would you explain it to me?
Weighs 5 pounds less than Sammy Davis Jr.
He does. He has a beautiful body, though.
Thank you so much, honey. And Bert Convy said I wasn't going to like you.
And he's wearing a satin shirt.
Satin, is
and
it?
It's fine.
Oh, we've got his number. All right, Silvana. Nellie said, my husband, the baseball player, thinks love is just like spring training. When we went on our honeymoon, he brought along a blank.
A glove.
A glove.
Not baseball
yes,
glove.
Yes, a baseball glove. I understand English. Well, you don't have to explain it to me. All right, Charlie. She said he
I'm
brought
so
along
nervous.
A glove on the honeymoon. Are you nervous?
Yeah, because I didn't... it's my first, and I didn't put glove, but
Well, you may have a good answer.
I don't know. I put down, brought along his third baseman.
So early.
Sorry,
You're getting started on the wrong foot, Charlie.
I know.
No, that's not a bad answer.
Charles, agony. You're only making us suffer, Charles. So sorry.
What do you say, Brett?
I speak Italian.
You do?
Mm-hmm. I said batetta.
A batetta. You brought along a bat.
That's how you say bat in Italian. Is that not true?
Charles?
Ball.
All right. The umpire. That's where he talks. Had a butch umpire that day at the game. All right, Joyce.
I hate his Chuck voice.
Well, you got here. Let me just see what we're
doing.
Guess
what?
I think my love is just like spring training. When we went on our honeymoon, he brought along a...
I'm a polyglotter, too, or whatever it is. I said glove.
A glove. Okay. Richard Dawson.
I don't know too much about spring training and things about baseball. I really don't. But I know that it can be tiring because they have to work out there. Is that right?
That's right. They
also
work hard.
Also, honeymoon can be tiring.
Yes.
So he brought along a relief pitcher, a teammate.
A teammate.
Well, that's someone to help him out.
That's right. Yes, of course. She's looking for the answer glove, Marcia.
Is she? Well, here we have what you call your synonym.
A synonym?
Yes, I'm sure you'll back me up on this, Gene.
Okay. All right, naturally.
Your pitcher's glove mitt. And or your catcher's mitt. Yes.
That is a mitt. That's good for you. Okay. Did I get it? All right, now we've got Janet's first round question, which reads as follows. I have a letter for you from the newspaper.
Well, give it to me later. Read the question.
No, here's it. Says, Dear Miss Beauty Hints, I followed your advice and soaked myself for an hour in lemon juice. Not only did my complexion get worse, but now I've got puckered blanks. Hello there, Joyce.
My this is a heck of a welcome to the show.
Show anymore.
Yes, you write an answer there.
I can't imagine.
Did you hear that, Janet? It's a letter from the newspaper, you know. It says, Dear Miss Beauty Hints, I followed your advice and soaked myself for an hour in lemon juice. Not only did my complexion get worse, but now I've got puckered blanks. Think about that for a second. Oh, you're not finished.
Look, I found last week's gum.
Get rid of that. No chewing or eating on this show is allowed anymore. Stop that. How are you, Charles?
I'm fine.
Good.
Under the condition.
Now, Janet Finn. Dear Miss Beauty Hints, I followed your advice and soaked myself for an hour in lemon juice. Not only did my complexion get worse, but now I've got puckered...
boobs.
Hello, Charlie.
How are you, honey?
I'm fine. How are you? She said, puckered boobs.
She did? Well, now she's got a pair of puckered boobs. Oh!
When I was a kid, I used to stay in the bathtub a lot.
Yeah?
My fingers used to get puckered, but I...
Anything else?
No. I just can't visualize this. Brett, would you help us out here?
I certainly will, and I'll try and be a little Tony, too.
Right.
I said puckered lips.
Lips. Splendid, my dear. Charles?
I said lips, too.
Puckered lips, okay. So we have two and two up there. What do you say down here?
I think she only soaked to her waist.
Oh, well, I'm going to be... That'll be enough of that.
She had puckered toes.
Puckered toes. Yeah. That happens.
Oh, well.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it does.
Like sure it does. Fingers and toes, right.
Thank you. that's a terrible thing to
now, wait a minute.
No, you can trust me.
I do trust you, Charlie. Yeah. I mean, you're...
But while I'm
you have tenure,
this,
you know.
Yeah.
You're not going to blow the whole thing now, are you?
While I'm doing this,
yes.
Call the unemployment... for you and me.
Right.
PB, as we call it, I could never... say puckered, you know. But I happen to know that her cheeks or derriere were puckered.
That would be more likely. Yes, of course. There. Marcia, what do you say to all this?
I say that I don't know whether to be worried when I agree with Richard or encouraged. I have cheeks.
Cheeks, okay. All right.
So there we are at the end of round one, ladies, and the score is 2-1 in favor of our challenger. And round two happens in a moment or so, but first we've got this for you. All right, here we go. I'll push this button, reveal our second and final round questions, ask Silvana to make a selection.
A, please.
A. A. Now, let's see. Marcia and Joyce were matched in the first round, so you two ladies will not participate. The rest will. Brett's always complaining about the questions being too long. You all agree to that, right?
Yeah.
Here, here.
Here, okay. Here.
Here, here.
There, there.
So,
we
got a short question for you. Bessie got blank at the OK Corral. That's it. Very short question.
What is it again? Brett got blank.
Bessie.
Bessie
Brett got
never
blank
gets
at
blank
the OK Corral. The star is talking.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Besides, it's my show. I'll explain it to him.
Oh, I'm Carol. Yeah, I wish you
would. Yes, you're finished.
She's joking, Gene, if you don't mind.
Sorry, I didn't mean it.
We didn't want to
throw her back in.
Yeah. She's too small. Anyway. Okay, Brett, are you finished?
Yes.
Bessie got blank at the OK Corral. Now we'll call on Silvana.
Didn't hear the question.
Yes. You know, Brett's always... Have you watched your show,
yes,
much, Silvana?
Uh-huh.
You know how Brett always complains about the long questions? Mm-hmm. Oh, we got a short one. Bessie got blank at the OK Corral.
Got what?
Well,
I guess her
blank
polyglot isn't working.
Bessie. Well, that's just a name. It could be Ruth or Georgine or who knows. Bessie got blank at the OK Corral. You know what the OK Corral is?
No.
It's a ranch. It's a place where they have horses and cattle and all that, you see. Bessie got blank at the OK Corral.
Ranchero.
How long have you been in my country? Can you think of anything?
Kissed.
Bessie got kissed at the OK Corral. Okay, that's what she says, Charlie.
Well, I...
She kind of drew
nice
a blank on that one.
I got... I put down Bessie got loaded at the
She got loaded at the OK. Down there with the old cowhands, eh, Brett?
Bessie happened to have been a cow, which everybody seems to have forgotten.
Oh.
She got lassoed.
Lassoed.
Or lassoed.
How did you like our short question?
I don't like them any better than your long ones.
I see. Okay, Charles.
It was a night she never forgot, she got branded.
Okay. Now, Richard.
Wyatt Earp, darling, was at the OK Corral, and he had a shootout with two or three dressmakers. They were tall fellows. You must have seen. Anyway, Bessie got preggy.
But she did.
Or as we say,
we'll
pass.
That Wyatt Earp?
Yep. That was
okay.
Wyatt.
So, Silvana, you didn't do too well with that. Let's see how Janet does. Now, Janet, you need one to win, one to tie, and two to win. Here we go. And if you do win it, it'll be your eighth game. Let's find out what happened. The ringmaster said, "Ladies and gentlemen, any magician can pull a rabbit out of his hat, but only the great Barzini, the world-famous circus magician, can pull a blank out of his shorts."
To Bessie.
Yeah.
He pulled Bessie out of his shorts. That's what he pulled.
Bessie said, "Ladies and gentlemen, any magician can pull a rabbit out of his hat, but only the great Barzini, the world-famous circus magician, can pull a blank out of his shorts."
What'd the first guy pull out of his thing?
Well, the traditional thing, Charles,
the
is
rabbit.
A magician pulls a rabbit out of a hat. You know, he says, anybody can do that. But only I, the great Barzini, the world-famous circus magician, can pull a blank out of my shorts. That's what I'm saying to you, ladies and gentlemen, with the greatest degree of specificity I can muster at my command here.
What kind of a circus is it?
It's a regular three-ring circus, you know, and all the things they have in circuses.
Hold on, three and a half.
Got animals and clowns and all that.
Oh.
Now, this is not, you know, we're not doing the Dead Sea Scrolls here, friends. It's a simple little game show with fun and all that. There. What, are you molesting this lady?
No, I'm not. She was whispering in my ear, and I'll follow her anywhere.
Right. I don't understand that. It was.
Okay,
did you read it in English?
Oh, she understood it. Yeah. Oh, boy, did she understand it.
All right. Now, here we go, Janet Finn. The ringmaster said, ladies and gentlemen, any magician can pull a rabbit out of his hat, but only the great Barzini, the world-famous circus magician, can pull a blank out of his shorts.
An elephant.
An elephant out of his shorts. That's a difficult trick. Brett, she said an elephant out of his shorts.
You know how I feel about Janet.
Yes, she's
sweet.
How much
I love her. Yeah. What a wonderful person she is.
And now...
I said the only thing he could pull out of his shorts was a bird.
A bird out of his shorts. Okay.
I told you I didn't understand the damn thing.
Well, I guess she didn't understand it. Birds, they pull them out of head. Doves.
I said dove.
A dove out of the head, yes. Well, I guess that would be what magicians do. All right, what do you say?
I said pull a carrot out for the other guy's rabbit.
Okay. Go to your room.
No, that's...
Richard?
And in case you wanted seconds, there's another carrot.
Oh, two in a row. Janet.
Oh, Janet.
Janet.
You've got
to match Marcia to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
It's you'll just retire a little old millionaire.
It's wonderful there's never any pressure on this show.
Are you nervous?
Yeah, real nervous.
Yeah.
Also wrong. A friend.
A friend. Congratulations. Okay, you've got $100. Stand by for a moment or so. Well, this lady is going to be very happy to leave. She would have been happier to stay, I suppose, but she has won an enormous amount of money. She set a new record here on Match Game 74. She's won more than any other single contestant. She's been just terrific. We've all enjoyed meeting you, haven't we?
Yes, Janet.
We've all enjoyed.
Marvelous, and we're so happy for you, Janet. We
know
you've got good use for the money, and we thank you for being with us. Janet Finn, $18,450. A little business with you, America, and we've got these messages for you. Then you hurry right back. We got another shifty lady here. Okay, now, Silvana, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Bing blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Next, $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard, please.
Richard.
A great Italian singer, Bing Crosby.
Bing Crosby, he said. There's one.
Charles.
Charles, what do you say?
Bing Cherries.
Bing Cherries, okay. All right.
Joyce.
Joyce, have you got one?
Yeah, Bingo.
Bingo, okay. So you got Bingo, Bing Cherries, and Bing Crosby. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do, Silvana?
Bing Crosby.
You want Bing Crosby? Okay. All right, so what we're looking for, we'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Bingo! Is the one Joyce gave you there. Okay, bingo.
Boy, they saved money on that sign.
Yeah, they did. Looking for Bing Crosby, may we see the $250 response? Bing Cherry. That's two out of three, Silvana. That may be a good sign. We'll find out if it's up there. Here is the $500 response. Bing Crosby! All right. Now, you won the $500. Come over here, woman. And you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000 to collect. You got to match one celebrity. Please pick one.
Richard.
All right, Richard, you get ready to write. Here we go. The $5,000 question. Remember blank. Remember blank. Ow. he's finished his response. Sivana, what do you say to match Richard? Remember?
When?
Remember when? Okay, for $5,000, Richard, may we see your answer?
Well, I'm not the best at American history, but I said remember the Alamo.
Remember the Alamo.
Oh, remember. Okay.
So, Silvana, you've got $600. You're going to meet another player, and you're still the champion. But first, we've got to take a break here and do this message for you. I just have a second to thank all of these beautiful, gifted people here for their efforts today and look forward to seeing them next time, as we will look forward to seeing you. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.